Hi. I decided I would have a go at building a module. So fortunately I bought this some while ago. It's a box of pins and headers and everything. So that one can be useful. Need the magnifying glass. I think I might cut down that background noise. Right then. I think I'll start with the sockets. My theory is if I put them all in with a notch facing upwards. Notch facing upwards like on the silk screen now. They're all the same size, these sockets. So that's it. So my theory is it should all be level. Basically. That's a theory. In actuality, it doesn't look to be the case. What's going on there? Oh, there's a bit of a gap. There's a bit of a gap between the socket and the board. Anyway, there's a little gap there anyway. That was putting me off a bit. So yeah, so this. That's it. So here's my iron ready. I've got a brand new tip on my soldering iron here. I just soldered a corner of each socket, and I can reappraise the placement and so on, make sure I've got it all correct. I don't put a lot of solder on. As far as I'm concerned, there's a hole that goes right through the board, and as long as the solder goes on the pin and adheres to that hole, then you know it's an electrical joint completed. So I don't think you need, you know, I've seen some people with their soldering, and from what I can see it looks a bit excessive. So I think they're all pretty level. I think that's good enough. Finish those off. by the way, I've got my little fan here. It's on very slow. I've got it on like 4 volts. It just stops the flux going in my bass. Might turn it up a little bit actually. Get a little bit more power. That's better. Just reflow a few of these. Yeah. So that's all that our C socket's in. What's the next thing? This one in. I searched for blue tack and I realised I didn't have any. So I'm gonna have to improvise a little bit here. Lovely. What's that one? What else we got? Oh yeah, this one.